Wimpy with the bookends.
All right, guys, welcome back. This is part two of our crab boil.
Part two, y'all.
A crab boil mukbang video. So this part, we're just doing the mukbang for y'all to see it, see what we made.
And see me eat, because I love those videos.
You know what I'm saying?
And I love crab. I'm going to be munching. This lipstick going to be gone. 2 seconds.
Period. But hey, y'all, make sure y'all keep watching. And that's all we got to say.
Yeah. See ya. Yeah, just want to let you guys know that in our previous video that we posted, we showed you guys how to make this good old seafood bowl. I was so excited. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna try this junk because, well, it's so good. This tastes better than. I've been waiting all day for food. I literally did not eat anything for lunch. I didn't eat barely anything for lunch and or breakfast because I wanted to save my stomach for this.
Is she telling her whole life story right now?
Like, it's so good. And I'm really finna get down and dirty. Like, my lipstick's gonna be off, everything. Mm-hmm. Like, this is good. Oh my God. Oh my goodness.
Straight heat, bro. I need potato in this, huh? Mmm, I'm trying to cool them.
If I can eat it. Mm. You can't eat this, baby. No. I need to get a knife or something. Mm. This is so good. Oh my God, you did the shell in here? Mm-hmm. I just ate shells in. I'm sorry. It's gonna get real ugly and dirty in here because I love me some seafood. You know, we got the king crab right here, y'all. And we got the snow crab. That's what I really been waiting to eat, is the king crab, to be honest. Mm-hmm. I've been thinking about it all day and all last night when we bought it. Ooh, I'm getting real saucy. I'm just playing. This is a non-alcoholic beverage.
And I think she lying. She ain't. It's Martelli's.
Yeah.
It's all we drink, because I don't drink, you know what I'm saying? I'm a clean body. Unlike some people.
You better hurry up, girl.
You better hurry up. Mm-mm. You don't want cutting the dog on corn off the dog on thing. Mm-hmm. By the time we're gonna be home, right?
Whatever. Dang, man. I'm mad I have to eat it like this. Looking stupid.
Disrespecting the food.
Mm-hmm.
Fire, bro.
So good.
Fire.
Oh. Is this supposed to be story time?
Maybe. What kind of story you want to get?
Me telling a story at the time that we got stuck down here.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Go ahead.
Okay, y'all. So this story was about back when I was in college. And Nadya, she came and surprised me for whatever reason. That when I was in college or whatever.
I surprised him. He was so shocked.
We'll upload a little piece of that video so y'all can see my reaction.
Yeah.
But
show y'all how scared he was of me. That's playing.
The thing, all right. So I didn't have a car in college, so I took my friend Trey car.
Shout out to Trey.
One of my bestest friends up in the whole wide world. You know what I'm saying? We got Trey, Deer, AP. You know what I'm saying? Jaden, Jason, got the whole gang, you know what I'm saying? Those are my dudes. But anyways, I took Trey Carr from, so I went to school in North Alabama, which is Florence, Alabama. And we was going down to Birmingham to meet my family. And
we supposed to have dinner.
Yeah, we were supposed to have dinner with my family. And my mom was getting to meet her for the first time and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But we took his car, not knowing that it was having some issues. I think he needed like a...
He was out of oil.
So he needed an oil change or whatever. His car was eating up oil.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like halfway there, I think. And we had to go up like a little hill. I was driving and then we got up like...
That junk really gave out.
Yeah, it gave out. We started rolling back.
Oh my God. I was like, babe, what's going on?
So we stuck in the middle of the street in country ass Alabama. I just knew the doggone. The hillbilly hijackers finna come get our ass.
Hillbilly hijackers.
I just knew we were some goners. But the whole time I was on the side of the road, bro, I was so embarrassed.
He was so embarrassed because this was the second time
we got to see each other.
Yeah, we got to see each other since our relationship.
And I just knew I was just such a failure of a boyfriend. Oh my gosh.
I thought it was cute.
This is the most embarrassed I've ever been in my life. Yeah, I don't understand. Cause this girl, I was mainly embarrassed because I was like, my time to show my driving skills. She got that dog on Camaro. I'm sure how I whip. At the side of that road, it was a whip.
It's King Crab trying to fight back.
Really?
Yeah.
We was on the side of the road for almost like an hour. Nobody was there.
He stuck on the side of the road.
That's the first thing you're gonna say.
Hell yeah. Hey. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we cool though. Cause she fine, and I'm alright.
And you fine.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We cool though.
Mm-hmm.
We waiting on my folks.
Mm-hmm.
My mother and my sister.
Mm-hmm.
My mom and my sister.
Why do you say it like that? Oops. I'm sorry.
Hey.
Don't even say nothing down.
Who I'm talking to? Who you talking to?
I don't know. Yeah, and then somebody tried to pull over and help, and then for some reason they like skirted off. Like,
I think they were trying to rob the dog on tires off Trey car.
They like skirt off, like.
It looked like they were just trying to see if like they can take some shit off the car, and then they saw what was in there. Like they saw his pop up, and then they just took off.
Oh, there's.
Yeah, raggedy. I don't want them on the side of the road with us.
Are they not gonna help?
Yeah, they not. I thought we was black. They was finna rob us.
Mm-hmm.
They was finna take the car.
What is this?
We had a good little time. We made the best out of it.
Yeah. We also made a video while on the side of the road too.
Yeah, we made like a couple videos.
Cause we've been wanting to start YouTube like since we got together. But we just never did it. But we do it now?
Yep. Make the best out of our situations. But long story short, my mom came and scooped us up because she's the real MVP.
Over the You said over the
She's the real MVP, y'all. And then she came pull up and
somehow we
made it to a gas station when we got back. We had to stop at every damn stop because the car kept overheating.
And then I had to go to the airport the next day at like 4 a.m. Mm-hmm. And we just got back at 1 a.m. So,
my baby, she finna go. She finna leave me. Finna take it to the airport right now. What'd you guys say to the keys, Lil Coupe?
Nothing.
Okay. I'm cool, babe.
I was extremely exhausted. Like,
yeah.
That's probably like the most exhausted I ever was in my whole entire life. Just then,
I was like, what a way to end the trip. We having some good times together, you know what I'm saying? For like almost 2 weeks, having some good times up in my dorm room.
But.
And I had to drive in the storm. I just knew I was.
It was storming.
Like, I couldn't see the road. That's how bad it was. Yeah. I couldn't see in front of the car.
He couldn't see, and like somehow we made it there. And then I had to like. No. I didn't miss my flight, did I? I mean, I didn't.
No.
We had time because remember we were sitting in the airport.
Oh yeah, you didn't miss it.
Yeah. And why I took him? This man was so sad. Mm-hmm. He was so sad. You know how you can look at the people, like check in and wave goodbye and stuff? He left because he didn't want to see me leave.
I didn't leave the airport. I left outside. I left from inside the airport, but I just sat inside my car and I cried for like 30 minutes. You know, I found
it. It was sad.
I cried the whole drive. My throat was hurting.
Oh.
So I knew it was gonna be. I ain't never cried for nobody in my life. Unless it was at a funeral.
Mm-hmm.
Never in my entire life have I cried for anybody, bro.
Oh my god.
What you for?
I'm getting there.
Talking about somebody better hurry up. He ain't nothing yet.
The whole time. I've been eating for 16 minutes.
Sydney was the best and the saddest time ever.
Yeah.
It was the best when she came to Sydney, because I didn't know she was going to come out.
He didn't know at all, because I was in training at the time, and I told him I was going to go home after I was in training, and so I kept like rubbing it in his face, telling him every day that I'm going home. Mm-hmm. So he had no idea I was coming. I was like, I can't wait to go home. I want to see my family. So, after training, I had a flight early in the morning to go to Alabama.
And she came and said,
bro. And I showed it.
Her and my friend Trey was plotting behind my back. No, I was playing.
It was all for the greater good.
Yeah, I was like.
He felt betrayed. He was like, how did y'all plan this? Mm-hmm. I don't know what it is, but I just love freaking surprising people. Like I always do surprises for people.
Yeah, she's good at like surprises and parties and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Something I've never been like really good at.
Mm-hmm.
thing big.
Can I get the doggone scissors?
Oh, I was really trying to say, can I get...
Oh, you selfish.
Can I get a piece of this? I was gonna say, heck no, bro. There's a whole freaking other leg. My guy. Excuse me if I have stuck my teeth, but my guy. I wish you had microphones, cause. Cause I was thinking about like putting the earphone. How are we gonna do earphones in this phone? It's all the way over there.
I don't know how we gonna do that. Let me see if I can get y'all a nice little close-up. These doggone king crabs, some bad mama jammers. I'm stabbing the hell out of my damn
face. Yeah, finish. I'm saying. They bite bad when we try to eat it, but I bite hard. I want this. This thing is so good every time I bite it. I don't know why, but every time I eat shrimp, like a shrimp,
shrimp, like a shrimp. Can I see this?
Oh my God, I'm so salty. Look at that one.
Dang good, bro.
King crab is fire. When I came down to see you, it was like I was on a little movie. Like, we went on dates. I get some stuff. I'm not gonna say nothing else. My parents be watching this. They said they be, they said they, every time we put out a video, they turn on the big TV.
Really?
Yeah, they watch every video we post. So,
that's what's up.
Yeah, and they said they'd be laughing, so I'm not gonna say nothing about the whipped cream and the chocolate. I'm not gonna say nothing about that.
Edit that out.
Hmm?
You gotta edit that out.
Yeah. Heck no, man. But yeah, it was so cute when I went down there. It was like a fairy tale. We went on dates. He got his nails did, what he got his toes did with me for the first time. And he was so embarrassed. It was so cute.
The doggone, the damn lady talking about some, she can make a necklace out of my damn toenails. They're so thick.
But, he also was laughing the whole time because his feet are like extremely ticklish, so fucking a fool in the freaking.
Until I'm a business.
He was really acting a fool in there. And I was looking at him like. But do you see this comparison of snow crab and the king crab? Like, look at his claw and look at his claw. I'm gonna eat this claw. Is it claw meat in here?
Yes.
I'm just gonna stab my finger. Anyway. Need a comment and tell us what we should cook next for y'all. Like, what do y'all want to see? Do you want to see us cook or make a pizza? Do you want to see us experiment with some stuff? Like, try to make our own candy or something? Do you want to see us bake more? Or do you want to see more of us? Because I see people skipping to the, well, watching the first part of the video with us in it, and then skipping to the end to watch us again. So from that, I'm thinking that you guys want to see more of us. But I could be wrong on that, but. You turn the video. But alright, you guys, so that's
That's our seafood boil.
That's our seafood boil. That's our story. And also that's whipping with the bookers. You gonna sing it?
Whipping with the bookers.
Whipping with the bookers.
Ding.
Ding. Alright, y'all. Peace out. I'm finna tear this one up.
Hey, hey. Plug. Writing this from Florida with love. When I link with Mexico, I.